Hi everyone, my name is Mr. Mahlalela. I'm taking you through computer practice M4. If you are still following me, I'm on my lesson 11 now. Today we are going to be discussing the following. We are going to be editing a document by creating the following. You are going to insert bullet and numbering. First, we are going to be inserting bullet, then we're going to remove bullet. Then we're going to be inserting numbering. Let me take you through a document that is already typed. So, candidate. In this case, we are going to practice by inserting bullets on a list of names. I've created a list of four names here, which is blue, yellow, red, and white. Now, if you want to insert bullets, you must first highlight those words in a line. Bullets, they work in a line. Remember that a word process, we have different lines. If you type on a line, then you move to the next line. You normally use enter to move to the next line. So after you've created the word following each other in a line format, you have to highlight them. We highlight the words, all of them, the ones that you want to insert bullet on. Then we need to go to home, on our home topic. Under our home topic, here on this box, under the paragraphs, there is this icon here. Mine doesn't have the word bullets, but if you click on it, it will tell you that these are bullets. Then press on the drop arrow here, you will find a different kind of bullet. Normally, on our N4 syllabus, they don't give us which a type of a bullet that they want us to put. But let's say, for instance, we wanted the square bullet, then we click on the square. Then automatically, all those words become into bulleting. The bulleting means that each word has got its own bullet until the last word. I'm sure you've seen how to create a bullet by now. The second part, we need to remove bulleting. Sometimes we'll ask you to remove bulleting on a document. If you want to remove bullets, because they are already there, first of all, let's say you want to remove this bullet, then we'll need to at least go in front of each word. Remember, the word starts here, then the bullet, it has got its own distance. We need to put our cursor mouse in front of that word. Let's use the last one, which was white, for instance. If you put our cursor mouse there, then on our keyboard, you press backspace. If you click on backspace, automatically the bullets become removed. But we need that word to be at the margin of the page on our left side. Then you press backspace again. And again, until you can see that now it is matching with the margin of the page. If you can see the words underneath this text, they start from here, which means that was our margin. Second word, same thing applies. We put our cursor mouse, then press backspace, backspace, and backspace. The other word, backspace, backspace, and backspace. Another one, backspace, backspace. Simple like that. I don't want to tell you the other way of removing bullets because I know you'll get confused. This way, this one is my easiest one. Then, lastly, we're going to be inserting numbering. Numbering works hand in hand with bullets. In most cases, it's either they ask you to insert bullets or numbers. Now, remember, I've asked you to insert bullets on words, the first one, the first four words that you were doing just now. But now I will insert numbers in this very same words. By inserting those numbers, I will need to highlight them as I did on the bullets. Then I'll go to home under the paragraph topic. Then I'll go to bullet to the next one, which is numbering. I click on the drop box. Numbering, normally they will just ask you to insert numbering, but if they specify, they will ask you maybe to to put numerical numbers, or sometimes they'll ask you to put what you call this these numbers, but I'm sure you can see them. Sometimes they can ask you to put numbering as alphabets, so it will depend which ones they've decided. Let's say in our case they wanted alphabets, then I click on this box ABC, then my numbering becomes ABCD, just like that. It can also be sentence where they ask you to put bullet or numbering. So if it was sentences, for instance, like the following ones. The first sentence is going nowhere. Second one is adjusting combo for tonight, and so on and so on. You do almost the same thing. You simply need to highlight. You highlight those words or those sentences until the last one. But make sure that the sentence starts at the margin of the page. The margin starts at the middle of nowhere, so that it can be accurate when we are inserting the numbers now. So if they ask us to put, for instance, numerical numbers, we go to home, then on the numbers you will take the numbering drop box, then you will take numbers maybe from 1, 2, 3 and so on. If you click on this one, then you press on, it automatically it numbers our words. Then at a point, if you want to remove, because of time, I can say it now. If you wanted to remove numbers that are already there, if they ask you to remove the numbers, you simply highlight the figures that have got numbers. You go to home, then you go to the drop box of numbering, then you click on none. It means you do not want any numbers. I didn't want to tell you this because sometimes it gets confusing on the students. Even if it was bullets or so. Let me say, okay, if you want to change numbers into bullets, like the first ones, it was numbers from A to D. I want to change it to bullets. Then I go to home. I go to bullets. Then I click on the bullets that I'm willing to change to. Then automatically it removes the numbering and change it to bullet. I'm sure if you keep on practicing it, then it will get more understandable and you'll enjoy it. I'm sure about that. So do not worry. Keep on practicing. Computer, it is a practice subject. Yeah, practice makes perfect. Without practicing, you'll end up not getting it right. Until we meet again, thank you very much for watching this video.